Now it's time to study about cows. Children, have you ever doodled on pages or on a piece of paper? Like, have you tried to scribble with your pencil or pen? Like this type of figures? Not a straight line, you can see. Itne sare mod hai isme. Ye kya hue? Curves. The pictures that are results of your doodling are called curves. These two curves, you can see, they are open curves. The two endpoints are not meeting each other. These, and these two figures, they form closed curve. What about this? This figure is a straight line. It doesn't have any curve here. So different figures you have seen, and they are all different type of curves. In everyday use, this figure will not be considered as a curve. We consider it as a straight line. But in mathematics, this is also called a curve. Now look at this two figures. They cross each other like this. This line is crossing the other line. Here in 8 also you can see these two lines are crossing. This line and this curve is crossing each other. Then these two figures are considered to be complex curves, or you can say, in other words, they are not simple curves. If the curves cross each other, then they are not simple curves. So these two curves are not simple curves, whereas these curves are simple curves where they are not crossing each other. And secondly, as I told you, these two are open curves because their endpoints are not meeting each other, and here the endpoints are meeting, so they are considered as closed curves. In a closed curve like this, there are three parts: interior, that is inside of the curve, boundary on the curve, and exterior, that is outside the curve. Very simple. A lies inside the boundary of the curve, that is, it's lying inside the curve, closed curve. So this is A, is in the interior of the curve. B is lying on the boundary, on the edge of the curve. So B is considered on the curve. It's on the curve. And if I take point C, if I talk about point C, then point C is outside the curve. So it is considered to be in the exterior. So this is interior, on, and exterior. Three regions you can say the interior of a curve together with its boundary is called its region. Now let's talk about polygons. Look at these figures. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 figures you can see. They are called polygons. What are they called? They are called polygons. Here, this is a polygon. This is a polygon. Then, this is a polygon. So, these are polygons. Okay? Whereas, this cannot be considered as a polygon, and this also can be considered as polygon. So polygons are simple closed curves made up of line segments. If we consider this a polygon, then the elements of polygons, you can see line segment AB, line segment BC, CD, DE, EA. These are sides of polygon. A, B, C, D and E are the vertices, are considered to be vertices of the polygon. These are sides, and angle A or point A, B, point C, point D, point E, they are vertices. A is the vertex. Vertex is singular form of vertices. And when we join the opposite angles with a line segment, then or opposite vertices with a line segment, then it's considered to be a diagonal. AD is diagonal. EC will be the diagonal. Then BE will be the diagonal. You can take BD also a diagonal. EC diagonal. These are considered. So sides, vertices and diagonals, you have understood from the given polygon. So what's a vertex? The meeting point of a pair of sides. When pair of adjacent sides, when they meet at one point, that point is considered to be vertex. As many sides are there, that many vertices will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 vertices. And you can see the sides also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5-sided polygon is considered as pentagon. Then AB and BC, this pair of sides is considered to be adjacent sides. BC and CD, adjacent sides. CD and DE, adjacent sides. DE and EA, considered to be adjacent sides. If we talk about adjacent vertices, then A and B, adjacent, and again A and E are also considered to be adjacent angles or vertices. Similarly, CB, C and B, C and D. Then D and C, D and E. They are considered to be adjacent. D and C are adjacent vertices. D and E, another pair of adjacent vertices. E and A, pair of adjacent vertices. Like that, you can get the vertices which are coming just after the other one, first. They both are considered to be the adjacent vertices. Here you can see the diagonals. You can have an idea of the diagonals clearly from this picture. AD, one diagonal. DB, another diagonal. AC, then EB, EC. These are considered to be diagonals. Next figure which we are going to discuss about is angles. As I told you, when two rays emerge out from one common point, then they form an angle. Here you can see figure 4.17. POQ is the figure of an angle. This is an angle, and it is formed by ray OP and ray OQ. So O is the vertex. OP, ray OP is one arm, and ray OQ is another arm of the angle POQ. Symbolically, we write this as angle POQ. Vertex has to come at the center. Name of the vertex POQ. You can read this as angle POQ or Q QOP or only angle O. You can read out the vertex name only. So now look at this figure. How many angles you can see? 1, 2, 3. Okay, angle A, P, B, angle B, P, C, and angle A, P, C, which is a combination of these two angles. When you add these two angles, you get the bigger angle, that is A, P, C. Here angle P, you cannot mention angle P simply like that. Here angle P means angle A, P, B plus angle B, P, C. That is angle P. If you want to name this angle, then you have to name it completely. Angle B, P, A or A, P, B. And if you want to name this angle, then you have to name it angle CPB or angle BPC. You cannot name it angle P because it is incorrect. For if you name it P, then it means it's angle APC. The whole angle. When you add these two angles, you get angle P. So while naming it, you have to be very careful. Children, let's talk about the region of angles. If I plot a point over here, then this is considered to be lying in the interior. This region inside this angle is considered to be interior of angle. Then if I plot a point on this and I name it E, then this point is on the boundary of the angle, so it is on angle. And if I plot a point here outside the angle, then it is considered to be exterior of the angle. So this region is considered within the two arms of the angle is considered to be interior. On the arms is going to be on angle, and outside, that is outside the angle, anywhere here is considered to be exterior region.